What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro DIY. Today, we're going to be working on a 2003 BMW E46 M3. Today on the M3 behind me, we're going to be replacing the throttle position sensor. This is a common failure item on E46 M3s. It's located right on the throttle body, usually, and it helps control the actuation of the valve and monitors how much air is coming into the engine. So when these go bad, you may have a weird idle, sometimes you may have a stuck acceleration, or you may have a completely shut valve giving you no acceleration. So that's just a couple of things to look out for when these go bad. Overall, a pretty straightforward job and pretty easy to get to. So let's take a look at some of the tools we're gonna need before we get started on this DIY. For this DIY, we're gonna be using a 1/4-inch drive ratchet and a small Phillips head bit on a 1/4-inch adapter. Now, depending on how your vehicle was equipped or if someone's been in there before, you may have different hardware. So just do a check, as you may have tamper-proof hardware, Phillips head, hex bit, or Torx bit screws. Now we know what we're working with for this DIY though, let's go ahead and get started on this job. All right, my good people, under the hood of the E46 M3, our throttle position sensor is located right at the front here underneath our fuel rail. Now, depending on whether or not yours has been changed in the past or someone's been in here before, your hardware may be a little bit different. In our case, we have 2 Phillips head screws. Oftentimes, you may find a Torx or a hex head on there, or in some cases, even a security Torx. So for us, it's going to be 2 Phillips. And like I mentioned at the beginning, we're going to be using our 1/4-inch ratchet with our small 1/4-inch adapter and a Phillips head hex bit. We're going to go ahead and disconnect our electrical connector. To do so, simply press on the metal tab and then pull off. You can lift that up and set it to the side. And then we'll take our ratchet and hex bit combo and just undo our 2 fasteners. Then with that, you can carefully pull off the old sensor. You can see the O-ring on our old one got stuck to the end of the RTB rail there, so you want to make sure that comes off with it. So we're going to go ahead and pull that off, and then we'll get our new sensor situated in place. There's our old O-ring. And take your new sensor and make sure you line up the keyed part with the keyed end here. And now it's just a matter of reinstalling our 2 screws. With those both snug down, we can go ahead and reconnect our electrical connector. Feed our cable down under there. And there you have it, my good people. Overall, a pretty straightforward job on the S54 engine. If you like this DIY, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave them in the comment box below. And if you like this video and you want to see more like them, please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.